episode 4, playing the Stingrays at the Gold Coast. Of course, we get that beach session. Down here at Glennon Park, the Stingrays Ravens matchup. It's gonna be a cracker.
Here with James Soup. Wooton.
The Close Soup, the star. The vlog theme this week is, why do you play American football?
I thought it was pretty cool on the PlayStation. Thought I'd better give it a crack.
Bro, that's how I started too. Yeah, which team did you play using Madden?
Seahawks, mate. Yeah.
Oh, fucking Seahawks.
Did you ever play any rugby?
Nah, never rugby. No, rugby. Soccer.
Straight from the soccer field to the gridiron paddock. All right, let's ask someone else.
Here with Braddy. Mate, why do you play American football? You're an Australian.
Yeah.
You're from the sunny coast?
Yeah, sunny coast, mate.
Surfer dude, come from the sunny coast, and he's playing American football.
Yeah, I found it a lot more challenging than AFL and rugby league. Just a lot more mentality into it.
A bit more strategy, you like
the strat.
Okay.
Not
okay.
Just running into each other or just kicking a ball, you know.
Yep. Okay, I like it. Here with an American, why do you play football?
What I play?
Why? Why do you play football?
I don't do it for leisure, baby. For the love of the game.
For the love of the game.
Go!
For the victory lap, though. Whoa, whoa. They ain't never seen nothing like this before. Lit the room when I came through the front door. Ask me if I should suffer, come, what for? Train in the trees, please park my sycamore. Touch burning sands, cross lands and stormy shore, shore seasons in the year, yeah. Ain't no challenge for champions and chain no fear. Yup, the champ is here, switch gears. With two hitters in the rear. At the blood, sweat and tears and my goal so near. I see my victory so clear.
I'm talking to players today. Why do you play American football?
Hey,
he would choose another sport. How about you, Mitchell?
I clocked cricket and soccer at expert level and moved on.
Hey, let's go! Ravens on three! Ravens on me! 1, 2, 3!
Ravens! Oh, fucking goal!
I know it's lonely at the tail.
Hey, Bessie.
Yeah.
You gonna give us your best today?
Haha! As always, mate.
Pun tracker.
Dad pun.
Alright, folks. Welcome to week 5 here in the men's division of Gridiron Queensland here. We've got the Ravens visiting the Gold Coast Stingrays, two absolute powerhouses in the men's divisions. Right now it's number 12 back deep to return, and back deep is this long snap over the head of punter Warwick Russell. So this game will start with a safety, ladies and gentlemen. Second down here. And this will be another Gardner give. Gardner breaks through the initial line past the first down marker, still going, and eventually takes the tackle there. On fourth down, they'll give it to Gardner, and Gardner's getting the job done, breaking through the secondary now for a Stingrays touchdown. No flags on the field. That is our first six-pointer of the day, and it comes in the form of Jonah Gardner. Stegman, give it to Fawcett. Fawcett looking tough himself and will grab 15 yards on that first down carry. Back to the pass they go. Climbing the pocket now with Stegman, evading a rush, trying to get Bones, and that's he does. Stegman with a 3-by-1 set. He will look for his isolated receiver. Is that Liam Edwards catching it above his head? Yes, it is. Nice catch there, working on William Mahe playing corner. Step to the left, and this is wide left here for Warwick Russell.
And the Stingrays, who have been running the ball more, went for a pass and another interception.
Stegman looking left and throwing for an open Bessie, who won't get the touchdown but will get more than enough for the first, and that will make it first and goal here for the Bayside Ravens.
And a very late flags come in.
This ball will be kicked from the 39 and it's wide left even more, and they're going to try to return this. Reese Perkins, an opportunistic player in a nutshell, and he will take this all the way back to effectively where the field goal was kicked. So if nothing else, he's got stats on his stat sheet. Oh, Jonah Gardner doing more damage up the middle, eventually taken down there by the safety and Jacob Eaton, but not before ripping off 25, maybe 30 yards. And a nice pitch play here from the former Keeper Park players. Jonah Gardner again, still not done with his day. 9 yards on that play here on fourth. Late bail there from the Ravens, and a dummy by Tonga Kilo before just manhandling his way forward. Fantastic. Tonga Kilo at the line, rolling out to the left, now shortening his strides as he, wow, is that going to be called a fumble? There are no whistles. The Ravens now, it's Eaton going down the right-hand sideline. He's just got linemen to beat. What a turn of events here for the Bayside Ravens, looking to give up their second touchdown of the day. They have added their first, but I still haven't heard whistles, I don't think.
The question here, it was a fumble. He wasn't down before the ball came out, but was the ball over the plane?
Gardner assessing his blocks and a good tackle over the top there. Stegman, top of the drop, throws an interception here, running it back for the Stingrays as it's safety there, and number 32, Christian Suarez, and Suarez takes this inside the 20. The Stingrays have the ball inside the Ravens red zone. James Taylor bowling over defenders. He's still going. Can he get all the way to the end zone? Looking for a signal. I think he was stopped a yard short. Up the middle, they send James Taylor, who meets Thompson. Thompson stands him up, and he backs his way into the end zone for a score. The Stingrays, this time not denied. You got trips out to the right, but it will be a delay for Forsett. Forsett will get the delayed handoff. We'll have to try and beat the efforts of a D lineman early, and that's exactly what it does. But now he fumbles the ball. We're going to have a bit of a scrum for the recovery here. Neither side, the over-under would have been interesting. But out to the right end. Now he's adding his first reception now, trying to dance his way past defenders. Warwick Russell-Bessie on the far side, but it'll be the late handoff to Forsett. Forsett, one big cut, gets him into the backfield, and he's got a first down and more, and now we're going to have a competition of athletic running backs, it would appear. This pile is still going. Already, 16-7, Ravens trail. They'll give to Holiday Miller. Holiday Miller bounces to the outside. Has to be the defender, can't do that. A great tackle there from McAlpine. A pass on fourth down. Stegman floors the run. He's got space now, but he's racing Malloy, and he will get the edge. Touchdown, Ravens. The Ravens close the gap here on a fourth and goal scramble there by Jared Stegman. Pass attempt here down the middle. Pass caught there on the curl route. Whistle signals in play. Tonga Kilo will try to do this on his own. Cuts back of the field. He'll certainly tempt that idea. Takes it into Raven territory. Eventually takes it from the Stingrays 35 to the Ravens 37. Short pass here. And that's Kluger. Kugler bouncing out of tackles and getting it out of bounds. Gardner out of the backfield, climbing the pocket now. It's Tonga Kilo. He'll just run with it. And he's got the weary veteran Jason Leon trying to drag him out of bounds. And that's exactly what he does to end the half. Terzok, ball is up, picked up in the wind. No chance. And there it is. Halftime here in week five in the men's division. And the Gold Coast Stingrays, they lead 16-14, top of the third quarter. Let's go. We got GQ week five action, and Tonga Kilo is taken down in the backfield. Defense, or pretty much both teams. Look at this play up the middle. Stuffed here. Another. No! Squirting out. Now he's wrestling with Chris Clark. Chris Clark has forced him to fumble so far today, and he gets a first down. Short pass here, slant to Jaden Palladon, who breaks two tackles. Now he's in the open field. He's dangerous here, but it'll be Jacob Eaton who'll take him down. Malloy playing more slot. This will be a fixture in this second half a bit, not just a package. He'll try to throw him. No, Tonga Kilo cuts back after a pump fake. Flags thrown in from the rearmost judge. Tonga Kilo, in the meantime, will cut back across the field, and from the 25, will take it all the way to the goal line, but flags are down. 20. Dropped, good pocket, almost touching the ball though, and it's intercepted by Quimby, and there's that trust you were talking about. A lofted pass taken away there. And this will be a gift to Holiday Miller, shot out of a cannon, splitting down the field, cutting back to the left-hand side there now, and will be taken down by the right boot. A couple turnovers each way. Tonga Kilo up the field, chased down from behind. He might have just got that back to the line of scrimmage, and the linebacker here tonight. Pass off the middle. I think that was a bit of the old stick concept, and they'll pass to the dueling around halfway last drive. Holiday Miller, they'll start this drive the same way They attempted the last. Holiday Miller racing up the left-hand side. We're calling a track meet here, but the sideline will put an end to that. Russell, he's in the right slot right now. Forced it in motion to the right. It's a least show to him, and then they try to draw to Holiday Miller, but Tonga Kilo, who is not receiving enough love on offense, feels he needs to go on D2, and he blows up that play in the backfield. And Malloy knows where the camera is. This is some old school noughties football, if you will. As Jonah Gardner keeps running through, they've got spiders on him. He takes his ball just shy of the Ravens. Roll out to the left for Tonga Kilo. He'll just back his ability now. Spins out of two tackles and eventually Brewer. There is Kugler. Looking that way, but now backs up and tries to throw over the middle. This is intercepted by Clark. Clark has got some pace, but not a whole lot of room to operate with. And the Ravens come away with takeaway number 4. He goes Fawcett with a bit of space. Fawcett dragging with a ditch, I think, with him over the first down marker. This will be another fresh of a game. Back to back. Pass over the middle to Holiday Miller in the slot. A stick contact of their own.
Managing to get the ball.
Trips left. Deep drop from Stegman. Steps up to avoid the pressure. Now he chooses to run with it. He's got a bit of space. Cuts back. Spin move. And he's still going there. And that's close to 20 yards on that quarterback scramble. Oh my lord. How quick did that defender shoot through? And how quickly does Stegman quickly recover?
There's a massive hole there. And that timing was
perfect.
Spot on, and I'm surprised Stegman is still alive.
That's Malloy. Someone
didn't know he was used to other teams.
Three-step drop from the pistol, open in the end zone. Oh, that would have been interesting. Two in the backfield. Stegman. We'll have to run again. It looks like that is the main order of the second half for this Ravens offense. Stegman with a quick motion. He wanted to hand it off, and then it will be taken down hard by Walters. Heavy pressure here from the Stingrays. Fawcett finds his way past it, but will not be able to beat the safety. And it's a bad snap, pitched out, quick speed option to Fawcett. He tries to stutter step on the inside, and a big stop here by the Gold Coast Stingrays. They continue to stay in this game with a 2-point lead. Big stand on the goal line.
The Stingrays take their first. So this could be a safety, and that'll tie things up, no?
Looks like he just got over the plane.
Back when the Stingrays played him. Through that exact same method. They try to pass there on third down and short down now. Third and 11. Stegman under pressure again, gets this out and two. Mitchell Bessie, who's hit as soon as he catches it. Handy on his field goal attempts tonight. That being said, neither field goal has. And they're going to get a free play. They're going to get it. That's going to be enough to move it forward. Malloy, who's been...
That is a stupid play by a leader of the team.
Blocking assignments. Holiday Miller now in motion to the right-hand side. Quick throw here to Bessie. Bessie in the corner of the end zone. Touchdown to Ravens. And the Ravens have the lead for the first time today. Malloy looking downfield. Intercepted. Going against that Dan O'Day. Now he's going to try and reverse field and take this upfield. Both quarterbacks now for the Stingrays. Responsible for turnovers. Bunch formation or a tight one even back. And Stegman. And now he's moving backwards. How is he going to handle this? Throwing downfield now to Bessie. Intercepted. Knocked down. That's athletic. James Sattel. No, it'll be read option. And Malloy will take this upside. Chris Clark. Athlete on athlete right there at the sideline. And they get up respecting each other there. That's a 9-yard carry there from Malloy. It'll be a pass. Quick pass out to Hariku Hatayar. And two veterans hooking up there on fourth down to convert. Clutch play there. Malloy. Clean pocket, but now he's getting pressure from the backside behind him. And look at him go. He shot out of cannon this time. Cut him back now. And Malloy takes this inside the 20. He's down at the Ravens 17. Malloy with four wide receivers divided equally. Slant over the middle. Touchdown, Stingrays. No flags. That will give them a 1-point lead on the touchdown alone. And is it any surprises who it is? Mr. Clutch himself, and Jaden Pelleton. To turn up here on this final drive. This will be the final drive of the night. Stegman under pressure. Lance Tonga Kilo. Only two with their hands in the dirt. Well, the Stingrays, they'll rush four. Downfield are a lot of receivers for the Ravens. Stegman beats the first rusher. Now he'll turn on his wheels and we'll get a first down and we'll have to take a timeout here. He does. Holiday Miller's going deep, as is Bessie. He'll be down inbounds here. They'll either need to spike it. That Stingrays are trying to suggest he dropped that. Worked himself into significant steps. Will they be the one to step up now and stamp their name into it? This is a catch inbounds.
And it's Bessie again.
So, got to stop it there. Got to explain something. This is the final drive of the game. 53 seconds left. Every quarterback's dream, drive the team down and win the game. It's 22-21 to the Stingrays. We have three timeouts. As you just saw, there's a couple of completions, inbounds and a running play. We call two of those timeouts, get a first down in field goal range. We want to set up the field goal center of the field. The referee tells us 18 seconds when he blows time back on after the chains are reset. We thought we could run a draw play in that time. Anyway, this is what happens.
An issue with the clock there, and the Stingrays just want this clock.
I don't think there's an issue with the clock. I think there's issue with Tim's knees. He's not getting the ball back.
3-1. Yeah, the clock resumes as soon as the ball's back in play. Force it now. This is a brave call to go call a run here, and that was the logic there. It makes complete sense. And there is the signal. That is the ball game. The Stingrays on their final offensive drive took the lead with a Jaden Paludan slant for a touchdown. And now their defense has finished the job.
Copped a brutal loss tonight against the Stingrays. What was the final score?
22-21.
Yeah. We had so many chances in the red zone. Just couldn't convert. Back to the drawing board. So there you have it. 18 seconds for a draw play. Admittedly, I took pretty long time to get the snap off, but that's kind of because we wanted just one play to win the game. We're going for the field goal for the win. So a pretty brutal way to lose. I mean, the Stingrays probably had a bad call at the start of the game on a touchdown return, because the referee apparently had his hands up for a touchdown, but then saw a fumble. You saw it on the film earlier, so tell me what you think it was in the comments below. But yeah, tough way to lose. I think having a clock at the field that you can see, that would be huge. I mean, the referees do have it hard, and I understand that, but that's a pretty tough way to lose. Anyway, on to the next game. Yeah. Peace.